On August 30, 1994, in a quiet town in Oklahoma, something puzzling happened. Bobbi Parker, a kind wife, mother, and teacher, suddenly disappeared from her home at a prison where her husband worked. She left behind a note, making it seem like a normal day. But as time passed, it became clear. Bobbi was gone. What made things more strange was who she disappeared with. Randolph Dial, a man in jail for a serious crime, but also known for his art. People wondered, did Bobbi go willingly, or was she taken by force? This isn't just a simple case of someone missing. It's a deep story about trust, choices, and the thin line between being free and being held against your will. How could a woman known for her warmth and love vanish so suddenly? As we dig into what happened that day and the long search that followed, we also face big questions about love, control, and what it means to be truly free. Where is Bobbi Parker? Finding the truth takes us on a surprising journey, challenging what we think we know about this mysterious case. Bobbi Parker, whose life took a path few could have predicted, became a beacon of hope behind the walls of an Oklahoma prison. Born and raised in a community that valued support and upliftment, Bobbi carried these principles into her adulthood. Her journey into the heart of the correctional system wasn't by chance, but a deliberate choice, driven by a deep belief in rehabilitation and change. In the heart of the prison, Bobbi found her calling in a pottery program, a space where art and transformation intertwined. Here, she wasn't just a teacher, she was a mentor, a friend, and a guide to those society had forgotten. Through her hands, clay was transformed into symbols of hope, teaching inmates that they, too, could reshape their futures. Bobbi's work transcended the conventional boundaries of education and rehabilitation, earning her the title of Teacher of the Year. This accolade wasn't just a recognition of her teaching prowess, but a testament to her profound impact on the lives she touched. Through her dedication, Bobbi Parker demonstrated the power of belief, compassion, and the enduring human spirit. Bobbi and Randy Parker's paths crossed in a way that seemed like fate had its hand in their meeting. They first saw each other in a setting that couldn't be more ordinary, yet for them, it was where their extraordinary story began. From the moment they met, there was an instant connection, a spark that quickly grew into something much deeper. Both Bobbi and Randy shared strong values of family and community, which became the foundation of their relationship. They knew early on that they wanted to build a life together, one that was centered around making a difference in the lives of others. Their decision to marry was made with a deep understanding of the commitment they were making, not just to each other, but to the shared goals they hoped to achieve. Together, they dreamed of creating a positive impact in their community, and this mutual aspiration only strengthened their bond. Bobbi's passion for education and rehabilitation matched Randy's dedication to his work within the correctional system. It was this shared commitment that guided them through their journey together, solidifying their partnership in both life and purpose. Randy Parker's journey in the Department of Corrections was marked by dedication and growth, starting with his early days at the Oklahoma State Reformatory. His work ethic and compassion within the correctional system set him apart from the beginning. Randy's belief in change and rehabilitation guided his career, leading him through various positions within the system. Starting his career at a young age, Randy quickly demonstrated a keen understanding of the system and a deep compassion for those within it. His approach was always guided by a belief in the possibility of change and rehabilitation, a conviction that drove him to pursue excellence in every aspect of his work. Over the years, Randy's consistent efforts and leadership qualities did not go unnoticed. Climbing the ranks within the department, he earned the respect of his colleagues and the trust of the administration. His career progression was a reflection of his hard work, as he moved from one responsible position to another, eventually becoming a manager. This role put him at the forefront of significant initiatives aimed at improving the correctional system, aligning with his lifelong commitment to making a positive impact. Balancing a demanding career with family life, Randy's dedication to his wife, Bobbi, and their children was evident. He was a pillar of strength and support, fostering a home environment filled with love and understanding. His story within the Department of Corrections and at home highlights a man who lived by his principles, dedicating his life to the service of others and the well-being of his family. The Parker family, rooted in love and mutual respect, navigated life's ups and downs together. Randy and Bobbi, united by a shared vision for a better world, welcome their children into an environment filled with care and understanding. Each child's arrival brought new joy and challenges, but together, the Parkers grew stronger, their home a haven of warmth and laughter. And Randolph Dial, the most interesting character in our case. Randolph's life before crossing paths with the Parkers was a tapestry of talent and darkness. Known for his exceptional skills in art, Dial was also a man with a past shadowed by manipulation and crime. His most notorious act, the murder for which he was convicted, painted a stark contrast to the artist persona he presented. Dial's ability to charm and manipulate those around him was well documented, making him a complex figure within the prison's walls. His crimes, including the cold-blooded murder, underscored the challenges Cowie faced in his reformative efforts. Dial, with his dual nature as a murderer and an artist, became a central figure in the unfolding story, illustrating the fine line between redemption and deceit. On August 30, 1994, a day that began like any other in the Parker household, the threads of normalcy would soon unravel, marking the beginning of a mystery that would captivate the nation. The morning light crept into their home on the Oklahoma State Reformatory grounds, where Randy and Bobbi Parker prepared for their day, unaware it would be unlike any other. Bobbi, known for her warmth and dedication, went about her morning routine, her actions echoing the rhythm of a familiar and comforting routine. Randy, immersed in his responsibilities at the reformatory, left home with the day's tasks ahead of him, the couple sharing those last mundane moments before parting. Their children, the heart of their home, set off for school, leaving behind echoes of laughter and the remnants of their presence. The day unfolded under the guise of normality, the hours ticking by with no indication that anything was amiss. However, as the sun began its descent, casting long shadows over the reformatory, an unsettling silence greeted Randy upon his return. The vibrant life that usually filled their home seemed paused, an eerie stillness hanging in the air. In the kitchen, Randy's gaze fell upon a note, Bobby's handwriting familiar, and yet, in that moment, a harbinger of the unknown. The note, which Randy found, was about Bobbi going shopping and the day planned. But as the evening wore on, the absence of Bobby's return cast a growing shadow of concern. The normalcy of the morning had given way to an unsettling silence, the note a silent witness to the mystery that had begun to unfold. As the hours passed, Randy's concern deepened, the absence of any sign of Bobbi or the family car amplifying the sense of unease. The night, usually a time of reunion and shared stories, stretched on with no word, no return. Randy, faced with the silence and the unanswered questions, found himself at the precipice of a search that would soon extend beyond the confines of their home, reaching into the depths of the community and beyond. Randolph Dial's time in prison was marked by a peculiar blend of respect and mystique among both inmates and some staff members. His freedom within the confines of the Oklahoma State Reformatory was not just a testament to his manipulative skills, but also to the unique position he had carved out for himself. Known for his artistic talent, Randolph was granted liberties uncommon for most inmates, facilitating his involvement in the prison's art program and allowing him a certain level of autonomy and respect that was rare. This respect was partly built on the elaborate tales Randolph spun, weaving a web of intrigue and lies that fascinated those around him. He claimed connections to the mafia, suggesting a life shadowed by underworld dealings and contracts that demanded a blend of fear and respect. Further embellishing his mystique, Randolph spoke of serving in the CIA, insinuating a past filled with espionage, covert operations, and secrets that aligned more with the plot of a thriller novel than reality. These stories, while compelling, were fabrications. Randolph's claims to an adventurous and dangerous life outside the prison walls were lies, crafted carefully to manipulate his image and status within the prison community. His ability to lie convincingly added layers to his persona, making him a figure of intrigue and caution. Through these fabrications, Randolph ensured that he remained a subject of speculation and respect, positioning himself advantageously within the social hierarchy of the prison. His tales of connections with the mafia and service in the CIA, though false, were part of the complex tapestry of manipulation and influence he wove behind bars, underscoring the duality of his character as both an artist and a master manipulator. In a move that reflected Jack Cowie's forward-thinking approach to rehabilitation within the Oklahoma State Reformatory, an intriguing proposal from Randolph Dial marked the beginning of a unique venture. Randolph, a convict with a complex past but undeniable artistic talent, saw an opportunity to channel his creativity in a positive direction. He proposed the initiation of an art program within the prison, a concept that aimed to offer inmates an expressive outlet and a step towards rehabilitation. Jack Cowie, recognizing the potential in Randolph's proposal, was not just supportive, but enthusiastic about the idea. He saw it as aligning perfectly with his vision of transforming the correctional environment into a space where inmates could find redemption and perhaps a new path in life. The approval of this art program signified a progressive step, emphasizing the belief in change and the power of art as a rehabilitative tool. The implementation of the program, however, required a suitable space, a challenge that was creatively met by utilizing the garage of Randy Parker, the deputy warden, and Bobby's husband. This decision was not taken lightly, but Randy and Bobby, deeply committed to the community and its rehabilitation efforts, agreed. Their garage, a space once used for mundane tasks, was transformed into an art studio, a testament to their support for Jack's innovative approaches and Randolph's vision. As the night wore on without any word from Bobby, Randy's concern turned to dread. The idea that she might not return on her own, that she might be in danger, became impossible to ignore. The man known for his strength and resolve within the walls of the Oklahoma State Reformatory now faced a personal crisis that tested him to his core. The initial reluctance to worry had evaporated, leaving Randy grappling with the harsh possibility that their lives might never return to the normalcy of that August morning. As the search for Bobbi Parker continued, suspicions began to coalesce around one individual, Randolph Dial. Randy Parker, along with law enforcement, couldn't ignore the peculiarities surrounding Dial, especially his recent behavior and his close working relationship with Bobby through the prison's pottery program. The fears were not unfounded. Dial had a history, one that painted a picture of a man capable of manipulation and potentially much worse. In the days leading up to Bobby's disappearance, Dial had been attempting to acquire Valium, type of drugs, within the prison, a detail that struck investigators and Randy as odd and alarming. This action raised red flags, suggesting premeditation and the possibility of a plan that involved Bobby. The fact that Dial was a convicted murderer added layers of complexity and concern to these suspicions. His criminal past, combined with his recent behavior, painted a troubling picture. Randy and the police feared that Dial might have used his influence and manipulation skills to involve Bobby in an escape plan, or worse, harm her. The trust Bobby had placed in Dial, working closely with him in the pottery program, might have been exploited. These suspicions were a source of immense anxiety for Randy, who knew Bobby's nature was to see the best in people, potentially making her vulnerable to Dial's manipulative tendencies. As the investigation into Bobbi Parker's disappearance unfolded, each lead seemed to evaporate as quickly as it appeared, deepening the mystery rather than clarifying it. Despite the tireless efforts of law enforcement and the community, the days turned into weeks, and the weeks into months, without any substantial progress. The lack of results from the investigation was disheartening. Randy Parker, amidst the growing despair, refused to take the defeat. His determination to find his wife became a beacon of hope in an increasingly bleak scenario. Randy leveraged every resource at his disposal, rallying community support and coordinating with authorities, but the breakthrough he desperately sought remained elusive. His resolve was a testament to his love for Bobby and his unwavering belief in the possibility of her safe return. The years passed, and with them, the case of Bobbi Parker's disappearance became a haunting enigma. The lack of results from the investigation only added to the intrigue, leaving viewers and the community pondering the myriad possibilities of what might have happened to her. Randy's refusal to give up, coupled with the absence of any conclusive evidence, painted a picture of a mystery that was far from resolved. The question of what happened to Bobbi Parker lingered. In the unfolding drama of Bobbi Parker's disappearance, a detail emerged that added layers of complexity to the narrative. After years of silence, Bobby reached out, but not in the way many expected. She made contact with her daughters and her mother, choosing to bridge the gap of years with voices that were familiar, yet had grown unfamiliar with time. These phone calls, a lifeline thrown across the expanse of absence, were a mix of reassurance and mystery. She asked how her daughters were, if they are okay, but did not give any detail about her location or why she's been absent for so long. They served as a sign that Bobbi was alive, a fact that offered a glimmer of hope amid the endless questions. However, Bobbi's did not call her husband. The decision not to call Randy, her husband, introduced a poignant twist in the tale. This choice, deliberate and loaded with unspoken words, stirred a cauldron of speculation. Why would she reach out to her daughters and mother, but leave Randy enveloped in silence? The absence of direct communication with Randy only deepened the intrigue surrounding her disappearance and the life she led during those lost years. This selective communication painted a complex picture of Bobbi's situation. It hinted at possible reasons behind her disappearance, the dynamics of her relationship with Randolph Dial, and perhaps considerations or constraints known only to Bobbi. The calls to her daughters and mother were threads of connection in a tapestry of disconnection, weaving a pattern of longing, love, and unresolved tensions. The questions these actions raised were manifold. Was it a matter of safety, or were there other, more personal reasons behind her silence towards Randy? In the sweeping search for Bobbi Parker, a critical discovery was made that seemed to hint at the direction of her mysterious journey. Bobby's minivan, a familiar sight to those who knew her and her family, was found abandoned in Texas. This discovery sent ripples through the investigation, as Texas was far from their Oklahoma home, suggesting a significant distance traveled since her disappearance. The van, empty and seemingly left in haste, offered no direct clues to her whereabouts or her condition. It was as if Bobbi and Randolph Dial had vanished into thin air, leaving behind this solitary piece of the puzzle. However, a seemingly mundane detail within the van caught the attention of investigators: a pack of cigarettes. These weren't just any cigarettes. They were the same brand that Randolph Dial was known to smoke. This small detail, while not conclusive, added a layer of connection to Dial, reinforcing the suspicions of his involvement in Bobbi's disappearance. The finding of the van in Texas, coupled with the cigarettes, offered a tangible link to Dial, yet raised more questions than answers. How did the van end up in Texas? What happened during the journey that led to its abandonment? The presence of Dial's preferred cigarette brand inside the van was a clue, albeit a frustratingly vague one, hinting at his presence, yet revealing little about the circumstances they found themselves in. This discovery was a moment of both breakthrough and bafflement for the police and for Randy Parker. It confirmed movement and potentially pointed towards their location, yet it offered no concrete evidence of their fate or well-being. The abandoned minivan in Texas became a silent witness to the ongoing mystery of Bobbi Parker's disappearance, a puzzle piece that fit into the larger picture, yet left the full image unclear. Bobbi Parker was announced missing on the newspapers, TV shows, and broadcasts. Her pictures were shared around the community. News shows also took part in her search. There were flyers pinned around Oklahoma. The finding of Bobbi's van motivated police and her husband to keep searching. It gave hope to Randy, lit up once dead hope to reunite again with his wife. Once forgotten case about Bobbi's missing was again in process, but unfortunate to Randy and his children, it lasted only few months and was again forgotten due to lack of results to find Bobbi. She was not found. It felt like she disappeared. It has been almost 11 years since she left house. Kids grew up. Randy did not look as young and full of energy as he used to when his loving wife was around. Even in more than 10 years of disappearance, he has never lost his hope and still waited Bobbi, the love of his life. On a day that would mark a turning point in the search, the show aired a segment on Bobby's disappearance. Among those watching was someone with a piece of information, seemingly small but significant, that they hadn't realized held the key to a mystery that had baffled authorities for years. Compelled by the story, this man picked up the phone and provided a tip about seeing individuals resembling Bobbi and Randolph Dial far from Oklahoma, leading investigators to refocus their efforts in a new direction. Armed with this new information, law enforcement officials delved into the lead with renewed vigor. Their persistence paid off. After years of investigations, this tip led them to a rural area where Bobbi and Dial were found living under assumed identities. The discovery was as shocking as it was relieving. After all the years, the countless searches, and the fading hope, Bobbi Parker was alive. The strategic and persistent efforts of the investigators, fueled by the critical tip from America's Most Wanted, showcased the power of community involvement in solving cases. It was a testament to the idea that no effort is too small and no detail is too insignificant in the pursuit of truth. This breakthrough in the case opened a new chapter of questions. How had Bobbi and Dial managed to elude capture for so long? What had transpired during those missing years? Stay with us as we uncover the remarkable journey from endless questions to the unbelievable answers in the continuation of Randy Parker's quest and Bobby's mystery. As we close this chapter, the mystery is far from over. Join us in the second part of this case. Don't forget to click on the part 2 to join us on this unforgettable journey. See you there.